The rebuild. So we're currently in season four right now, and here's what the team's looking like. So I got Neymar for free as a pre-season in season three. Same thing with goes for Kylian Mbappe for free, 95 rated player for free, and Ousmane Dembele. Now we got players like Eggenstein. These players are great. He's so good. 25 years old. Aaron Wan-Bissaka, Kante, Maluke, Pickford, Hernandez, Jonathan David, and Erling Braut Haaland, who's amazing. I got him for 34 mil, I think, when he was like back in the day when he just started playing for Dortmund. I got him in the first season. Now Rashica's been here. Rashica, whatever his name is, has been here for the whole rebuild, and he's past his potential by two. So he's actually meant to be 86, but he's 80. Proves that players could go over their potential. Same, we got Adam Hulsek no, second season, because in the first season, Slavia Prague. And this is Ricardo Quaresma's region. Now that we've explained everything, let's get into this season. Hopefully, this is the last season. Last season, we did the domestic double, but if we win the Supercoppa, then really and true, if we win the Supercoppa, if we win the Super Cup, sorry, then we've done the domestic treble, which is really good. Yeah, that's good. So Atletico Madrid, yeah, we put Rashica on the loan list, but if a player gets injured, bringing him back would be a really good idea to consider. 88 rated player going out on loan, pretty good. I had the perfect picture. It was all laid out for me, but I feel like I'm in love with the paint fan because it's the same old story. We have so much money to work with. I don't know who to sign though. We probably, maybe I should sign a really good defender and loads of backups. I'll get De Ligt, might as well. De Ligt. Guys, consider this. Yeah, we started off with 18 mil at the start of one window. I think, no, we started off with like 7 mil in the first window. Obviously, money glitches and stuff are patched, so I've just got to this now. One of my favorite players in the Eredivisie, Denzel Dumfries. We'll sign loads of backup. Who are really good backup players? Oh, I hate Andreas Pereira, but he must be decent. We'll get him on the cheap. Might as well. Can't be asked to scout him either. Yeah, but we'll probably get him on the cheap, so. Let's go to our rivals. Who are our biggest rivals? I'd say are Bayern Munich, in terms of Bayern Munich and Borussia Dortmund. We compete with them for the league every time, and they are really good contenders for the league. So, yeah. Who do we sign from here, though? That's the question. Ooh, Jose Maria Jimenez. Could be an absolute bloody steal. He's a big guy, he's good at football. Oh, who's this guy? He seems good. I mean, he has potential to be special. All right, that's enough of Dortmund. I've had enough. I don't really want to scout any more players from there. Now, FC Bayern, the big boys. Anyone, any of they got any players that I should know about? Wait, who would play? I could get Cesc Fabregas' region. Fabregas, oh geez, I passed the Ligue 1 time ago. Yeah, any team in Ligue 1 and very young nationality, they have to be Spanish. Let's see. And this guy is Cesc Fabregas' region. Just like that, boys, just like that. Now let's head on over to Transfer Hub. I've got a lot of random players on my Transfer Hub, so just... Yeah, loads of random players here. Oh, Brielle Mbola's potential is not terrible. I mean, it's even with Calvert-Lewin, so... Same with Wesley. I thought Wesley had better potential. Alright, so... Here, so this guy first of all has potential to be special. All right, they've recently joined. Wait, so he's around 70 million to 100, and he's cheaper. What? How does that work? Alright, I want to sign. Is this guy Ribery's region? Yeah, I think so. It's Ribery's region, so. We'll sign him up just because. Why not? They say one day. Remember? Nah, you guys, we're such a poor club. I'm gonna have to play hardball. Nah, I don't have that kind of money. Oh, okay then. If they're gonna stick to 5 mil, I'll accept it, because we clearly have quite a bit of money in the bank. So, and I want to get Ribery. You know, Ribery is great. Why not get his regen? Of course, I just want him to be a breakout star, but he'll play a bit as well. So let's see what he is saying. You see, that's Ribery. Like he probably, if he's that, but that's Ribery's regen. You can just tell. All right, we'll trade them a decent defender. We got him in the first window, so I'm happy to swap him. Where's he at? Melikly, and a bit out of my budget, I'm not gonna lie. I don't want to spend that much. Sorry if there's any background noise. There we go. And that's how you call yourself a FIFA pro negotiator. Don't really know about my heritage out here doing what they never did. No. That's probably why I got so many relatives. They've been listening to that song for how long now, bro? Okay. No release clause. I hate release clauses. They must be an idiot to... Like, the biggest release clause I've put on a player is probably, like, I've put like a 300 release clause in. I'm just not an idiot. There we go. We got Delit even his contract is kind of cheap. Break me. Hit it. Not there with me. But can you break clear with me? What's this wrong? Cyclops. You can't enter me. Ooh. Fred's had a really good season this season. And hopefully he can be a really good player for backup. I want him to be a part of the bench. And if he doesn't want to be a part of the bench, he's not coming to the club. He must be bad by now. Like, he must be worth around 8 mil. Jesus Christ, why is he so upset? Relax, my friend. The thing is, I want to get Dumfries. Oh, he's too important. What am I meant to do? What the hell? Oh, this is just annoying now. Now I don't know who to get as a backup. Oh, Sandro Tonali went to Crystal Palace. What a waste of a good player. Millet. Nah, you can't try and sell him for that much. This is what I hate. Later in career mode, players get so much more expensive. Now I don't know what to do. Now I only spend my evenings. She was my favorite. She was my favorite. I don't know who the best left back in the game is. So clearly a very good team. And I don't know what to change about it. Jonathan David. He's so good. He's been such a good sub. He's been such a good how do I put it? Yeah, we'll just look for some bench quality players in the Prem. No, I don't know what to do. I swear that guy's good, he's high potential. My favorite. She was my favorite. I'll just sign Ross Barkley. How old's Harvey Barnes? Harvey Barnes must be pretty good. Can I scout him? I mean, it'll take too long, but whatever. No. I'm so confused right now. Jacqueline Carrera, Douglas Costa. Has he still got the demon pace? If he has 90 dribbling, it's obviously quick, so. Alright, now that. Oh, fuck. Ross Barkley, we'll get him, and we better get him on the cheap. The hell? We better get him on the cheap. $12 mil for a 28-year-old. Wow, you're mad. No way, we're not going over this. You're crazy, bro. He's mental. Frank Lampard, I hate getting into arguments with this guy when we're dealing and we're doing a transfer deal. I don't understand, like, you guys will see why I play hardball so much in my transfer negotiations. It's just the saving money part is so good, because unexpectedly you never know where you can end up. But you see what I mean, a 28-year-old Ross Barkley's costing me, they wanted 20 mil for him. He's too old for that. Yeah, we better win the Champions League within 3 years or there's going to be a problem anyway. Let's see how what this guy's rating is. You see, he's only 82, really good backup player, but he's not all that. I don't know why they think he's worth 20 mil. I think that comes too soon. Party everyone, roll through. Alright, I'm gonna get one more rotational player. And that is gonna be. That is gonna be. The banging Andreas Pereira, who is not so banging in real life, but he's always been overrated in FIFA, so. I'll see how my guys do. Well, I actually hate this guy in real life because of how bad he plays, but. Yeah. We want to offer a transfer fee. He's a bit young, so we'll offer 23 mil. There we go. Now, guys, I'm kind of getting bored, so I just want to spend more money. And I want to make it easier for you guys to watch and not painful. Because we're by far one of the richest clubs in the world now, with all this P. At least people know their place in this, you know what I'm saying? Like, at least people know where they should be. In terms of roles, 60, and yeah, why not? We've got the money, and we might as well secure another sign in. Now, what's his rating? He's along the same lines as Ross Barkley. Loads of good backups, really. Two backup midfielders, we might need a backup striker. Luis Roberto Dalves. Not actually in a real club of the game, so we're probably. He's sometimes a free transfer, sometimes not. Depends what he's feeling. 18 mil. You see, the cash goes like that. Look, we're already on 40 mil now, and we started off with 170. Or when you want to bring in the big name players, that's what happens. Rotation. Yeah. He's being compliant. Nope, no. Let's see if we can not give him that much. I'm expecting them to be at least 79, 81. What can I say? Exceeding expectations. And those are three great backups, all over 80 rated in the Dark Greens. There's one guy I'm gonna search for, who is the player I've created, and he was being a whiny little bitch and I sold him. Marcelo. No. Let me see if I can find him. James Marcelo. Up to your mom and down to your wife. I want to see what he looks like in a PSG kit. With him, I kind of tried to make him look a bit like Rodrigo, the Wonder Kid. He doesn't look too bad in this PSG kit. I did an alright job, and he's 20, and I made a high, pretty high potential player. I'm tempted to sign him. All right, now time to sort out the bench. Which of the two regions? Oh no. All right, I need to figure this out. Rashica, I need him to move. Learn offer for Adam Holsek. Yeah, if we can get these two loaned out, there's space for everyone that I got as a rotation player. Adam Holsek expects to be crucial, and I can't give him that type of game time. So, what's it gonna be? I think it's gonna be... Yeah, Pereira can keep that number. Same with Ross Barkley. Who was the other guy? The backup striker. Oh, that's sick. He's got a good number for a striker. You know what I just noticed? Erling Haaland has got the number 17. He can get the number 9. And Davies can get the number 17, like Erling Braut Haaland. Look, wow. Has that special something? The one of the world's best has potential to be special. Haaland wants another contract, so we're just gonna negotiate his contract. You guys can skip ahead a bit if you want. Just gonna renew his contract. He is not happy with his 55 mil. Fair enough to him. He's been the best club, best player at the club for a while now, so. He wants less money. I don't know what to say. Erling Braut Haaland. Alright, now guys, I promise we're gonna go into games. Let's simulate and see what happens. Rashica loaned out. And Holsek loaned out. Yeah, got quality on the bench though. Alexander Nubel. I want to see what they look like in their kits at their new club. So in a Roma kit, cool. Let's see if the Atletico Madrid kit suits him. Nah, he just looks normal. I forgot he doesn't have a real face, which is a bit annoying. Let's clear this up. Interest zone in. I might get a rotation defender because that's the only thing I haven't got in rotation, and that's the thing I keep getting too many injuries in. So a rotational defender might be a shout. He might poke this guy from his bum. Let's see. Oh, I wanted to delegate this, but offer fee. We're gonna go a few dollars ahead of what they wanted, and now delegate. Start at 20 mil. You will start at 25. Start wage. 25. I gave him nothing for wage. Retract. Fuck. I fucked up. I don't know how to delegate you lot. This is why I don't delegate players. Oh, I don't know what to do. Who's a good defender that I can get on the cheap? None. Unless I got Nathan Ake. Boom. Who's the scout report on? Harvey Barnes. He's pretty decent for career mode. Guys, I just got a notification from my friend, which is an absolute shout. We need to swap Mbappe and Dembele. I'm sorry if that triggered any of you. Like, that kind of triggers me now that I think of it. But yeah, Haaland and Mbappe, Mbappe and Dembele needed a swap. Who's got an injury now? Mother's life, if it's one of my defenders, I'm gonna get so angry. Aaron Wan-Bissaka, come on. That guy's crucial. I don't know what to do. We're gonna play the Super Cup, and you guys can see if I'm good at FIFA or not. So, here we go. Here goes nothing. Alright. Yeah. Hey, we need to boost their morale in that. And make them. Yeah. Alright. So daylight comes too soon. Dun-dun-dun-dun-dun. After party, every run, roll through. Don't matter where I go, as long as I go with you. Too soon, guys. As you can see in the top, so right where the stadium and kickoff and stuff is, you can clearly see that I play on legendary. No way. So yeah, I play on legendary, and that's it. I just play on legendary. So. Thank you. Alright. So, Dalvez, he's gonna be more on the pecking order for who we need to bring on. I'll see you soon, everywhere, I'm gonna bring them through. Got a shout out to Galdem too, that's a daylight comes too soon, that's a daylight comes too soon, everyone. Got a shout out to Galdem too, that's a daylight comes too soon. Yeah, just in advance, I'm sorry I had to say it, but I am legendary on legendary difficulty, so we'll see if I play bad in front of the pressure of millions of my viewers. That's a joke. I know some people are going to be crying about that in the comments. Unai Simon, or whatever his name is. Quick, finish. Are you? Oh, that was so retarded. Why did you run? Oh, and Werder Bremen are a very struggling club. They do look like they will be getting relegated this season unless the Bundesliga gets null and voided. Which is a shame, but if it happens, it happens. We're at our stadium for the Super Cup. And we've got Eggenstein as captain. Now, it's Werder Bremen versus Erling Braut Haaland. I told you, all I'm saying is I play on legendary right now. You can go rewind it and check, bro. Wait, guys, just check the team real quick. Fourth season with Werder Bremen. This is how the bench is looking. Wan-Bissaka's injured, so I decided to let him rest for half the match and then bring him on. Haaland scores. He's one of the world's best players right now. Haaland, what a banging player. Oh, why is Mbappe back there? I was wondering why the guy's so fast. Ribéry's regen. Cannot kick a ball properly. Nice. Alright. Quick. Are you? Oh. Now this season we probably will win the Bundesliga twice in a row because I got Mbappe, Ousmane Dembele and Neymar Jr. on the free. What the hell am I doing? Take a touch. Oh my days. Fuck's sake. Hernandez. Fuck. What am I doing? I'm so confused on stream. SV Werder Bremen versus Bayern Munich, who don't come close to our level of skill. Oh, also I was meant to get Nicolas Sule on a free, but that didn't work out. Now to Pickford. No. Okay. Quick run. Alright, lay it off to the supporting player. I tried keeping cool with it, but that didn't work out. Now they're playing Rondo. Wait, I want to see if my keeper's one of the best in the world. Nope, not yet. One more rating higher and he'll be the best in the world. Like, how old would Alisson be? He's like 26 in real life, so he would be 30 years old and probably like way lower rated. because Neymar went down by 2, now that he's 30. But I got him for free, so I'm not complaining. 91 rated player. Oh, he's 90 now even. You see, slowly but surely, Neymar going down, down. I think this is the first career mode I've signed, like, Neymar and Mbappe. This is a sick career. Unai Simón, good keeper. Oh, Jonathan David. Fuck you, kid. Oh, shit. This nigga's one of our best players. And then the Sunday League ref comes and tells him to get off the pitch. No, obviously the game's not going to be changed. Come on, dude, do the... Oh, that's why I wouldn't let me do his celebration. Now he's got them. Now Eggenstein. Are you fucking kidding? You've got to be joking. That's two crossbars. Oh, now I'm looking so trash. This first half has been AIDS. I should be beating them at 5-0. Jonathan David got a red card. What a piss take. Neymar rocking his number 19 shirt. Ooh, shit. Imagine if that one was a red card. Alright. Delete. Lovely clearance from Kuyante. We are not doing good. You're not doing good in the second half. Lovely. The lit clearance. Alright. Now Theo Hernandez. Out wide. Frenchman. Ousmane Dembele. That's a banger. That was a beauty. That was a beauty. Ousmane Dembele. Oh, someone's still watching. Aye, get in the comments. You're a real one. Thank you for still watching the stream. Hope you're enjoying. Get in the comments. Say hi or something in the comments. I'll check your comment and see if I know you or if I don't. I'll check your comment. There's one guy in the stream right now. Thank you so much. I appreciate it, bro. I appreciate it. Alright. Oh, my nigga commented. Thank you. Let me check. Let me see who this is. Oh, it's Lucas. Man, like. What are you saying? Oh, live. That's one of my bros. Now Neymar. That was fucking 30. Alright. Oh. I'm having quite a fumble. Lovely tackle. Now through. Neymar Jr. for Nigeria FC. Oh! You got a... You can't make this up. Don't worry, they can attack. I don't care. I'm checking my comments. What are you saying? That's a mad career. Thank you so much. I spent 4 seasons on it, but finally, it bangs differently. Imagine, I got Haaland for 37 quid. No, 34 quid. Haaland, and now he's the world's best striker. Then I got Mbappe, best player in the world for free. Jesus. No! It's good goalkeeping. Oh, 70th minute. Neymar's getting tired. He's an old man though. He needs his walking stick on the pitch. Who do we bring on? Ross Barkley. Why not? Ross Barkley. Then we'll put on Dalvez. And I'm gonna move Haaland to the wing because Haaland's already got like 99 pace. 99 pace, 99 pace for Jonathan David, 99 pace Mbappe. What can I say? What can I say? My player's got too much pace. Too much pace. We're running the whole German game right now. And now, substitutions for Werder Bremen coming onto the pitch. Number 17. Dalvez coming off the pitch, number 19. What's his name? Neymar. I wish they did that in FIFA. I like it when the board people in the games do coming onto the pitch. That bangs. Yeah, you're on the ball, but you're not producing as much as me. Go on, go on, go on. Eggenstein. Now, lovely tackle. I'm 30. Now play it through. Now Eggenstein, the captain, leader, legend of Werder Bremen. He will be known as a Bremen legend. Who's Marco Reus? Who? Marco Reus, who? It's all about this guy. This is the German wonder kid. The tale of a German wonder kid, bro. And it's Eggenstein or whatever his name is. Maximilian scores another. And it's 3-0. Alright. No, Mbappe seems to be getting tired. If you want, you can dribble forward, Skimmich. Oh, this guy's good. Awar. I brought him into Chelsea or Blackburn Road. No, Chelsea. Yeah, I've got him to Chelsea. Now Dalvez. Now Eggenstein. Go on. This is what I mean. They play the worst football on Legendary. They're so possessive. All they do is keep possession. It's pretty gay. Oh, shit. Guys, I don't mean that. Obviously, there's nothing wrong with that. And I don't know why I said that. But I don't mean it, I promise. How is this Donny? This type of Donny? I won't specify anything. Yeah? It's nothing horrible that I was going to specify, but something that I would usually specify around the bros, yeah. So how is this Donny saving that? And we've done the domestic treble, boys. Eggenstein lifts the trophy. He's a captain. He's a leader. He's a legend.
Mm-hmm.
just let you guys watch the celebrations, and celebrations are over. Of course, they haven't won the Champions League. I'll show you that banging goal by Ousmane Dembele if you guys want to see it again. Just a quick little replay. And that's what your boy can produce on a legendary, you know, legendary role. Legendary who? Legendary what? Jeez, the ratings were a bit harsh. Pickford did good. How many saves? Zero, fair enough. Alright, Unai Simon deserves so many ratings. He carried their team, even though he let in three goals. The rest of their team, it was just a kind of David Alaba. But yeah. When I go, oh. Why didn't Pereira make his debut? What a bitch. Why is he already unhappy? You're a rotation player. You just got to the club and you're starting to cry. Vexing me. Just vexing me now. I'm not making Matthias the lit captain, no way. Eggenstein is captain and he stays captain. And here comes rushing back. And here comes rushing back. Alright guys, Jonathan David is not loud since the bastard BH got red carded, so he's not allowed to compete in today's game. Pereira made his debut. I would expect to smash them, like last season we smashed them 4-0 on the last day. Actually no, it was like 3-1. Alright, now Jonathan David can go back into the team. Mother's life, my career is so sturdy. Most certified thing. Jeez, Bayern aren't even in the top six. We've broke them. FC Augsburg. This is light work. Augsburg who? Come on, boys. I don't think one season we've played Europa League. No, we haven't. We qualified for the Champions League in the first season, beating all the odds with a really, really mediocre team. It's like, I think Werder Bremen are Arsenal's level in terms of team sheet, with a few hidden gems that not a lot of people know about. Eggenstein's one, Rashica's one. Those two are gems. Pavlenka's a good goalkeeper, but I sold him because I got Pickford for free. Ooh. What's our draw saying? It always say we get lucky draws. You know, Napoli, Sporting, and Sparta Prague is not that easy. I don't know why it says we got lucky. It's not necessary. Like, we got PSG and we got like Real Madrid and Man City in the same group once, yeah. And they were telling us lucky draw. I'm like, what the hell? I don't know. Schalke. Now I'm gonna do this in true rebuild fashion. We're gonna sim to the last game, and it's gonna be the game against Napoli. No. Okay, so now we have a game in hand against the Napoli. Hopefully we've won this bloody game. I swear to God, if we don't win this game, I'm not gonna be happy. I swear if we're not top of the group, I'm gonna not be happy. Or people whiny bitches about everything. So we've had an injury. Alright, I didn't even know we had that guy in our team. He's got an injury. Jesus Christ. Jeez. Ah, wah, woo. I'm surprised we're not the worst team. If we're not in the Bundesliga relegation zone, you know we're doing well for ourselves. What's the team saying? We got our best player injured. Oh, what can I say? This is why I got Neymar, bro. Neymar's so clutch. Like, in this situation. And this is why you buy backup players when you've got that budget. You got all that budget, too much. You know, no one uses it to their advantage. Spendy. Oh my days, Pickford's injured. That's why we have Nubel on the bench. Nubel. Alexander's Nubel. The next Manuel Neuer in real life, but in FIFA career mode, not so much, unfortunately. I think he should start off with a 78, 79 rated, and then have a good potential. Let's see what the groups are saying. So, wait, we're just gonna, all right, group A, Atletico Madrid, unbeaten in the group. With any games in hand for their group? Yeah, game in hand against Piemonte Calcio, who have also not lost a game. They have both drawn. Maybe they've drawn to each other. PSG obviously winning the group. They've poached one of our best players in Marcelo, but he doesn't have a space in the squad, so I guess he's not one of our best players. Same goes for Olympique Marseille. What are we saying? Come on. No win. I mean, no losses, one draw, and yeah, pretty decent. Good results only, bro. No L's. We'll all have to see if that's true after this game. Let's see. What's the score? Come on, FIFA. 2-1. Dembele and Neymar get the goals. I feel a bit bad for Merit. Alex Merit, but competition's competition. I don't really care as long as we're winning. We are third in the Bundesliga behind we're behind Frankfurt. Like, Frankfurt can't be underestimated in this game, you know. They are too good. Damian Pickford, one of the best in the world. Oh, he's not happy with his contract. That's definitely getting renewed. Best keeper in the world here. Can't tell me no different. As bad, he is in bad form, but he's crucial. Best keeper in the world, as I said. In 3 years' time, he becomes the best. The beast. Damian Pickford. Pickford is here for another 5 years. And dislocated shoulder, fit in 4 days. Alright. This guy, oh, he's the injured one, peak. Dennis Bliff. Advance. Negotiate. I don't want no release clause, are you mad? Are you mad? No release clause is involved, my nigga. No release clause. Jonathan David, bro. There will be no release clause involved. No release clause. That's what I thought. Nice to have you on board. As much as it's a £200 million release clause, I'm still not having it. Kylian Mbappe's fit in 4 weeks. Bit peak, but oh, this guy's bare fast. We have so many good players. One of the world's best. Come on, become one of the world's best. Use one. Believe in you. No. Damien. Big D. Me. And pick forward. He's only going to be fit in a month's time, which is around January 6th. Fit in a month, that's peak. Oh. Put in this blue. Stop. I don't know what I get for him. Coronavirus. Oh, I hope you guys are all well as well. This coronavirus thing, obviously, it's not very good, but what can I say? Coronavirus, you know, just rocked up. Like, just is here, so is what it is, but yeah. Now there's an ambulance next to Usman Dembele, so I don't know what to do. He's fit in 3 weeks. He's fit in 4 days from his torn hamstring. All right. We are not doing well in the season, but injuries are hitting us hard. Injuries are just coming thick with freezes and fast. Like, I don't know, they're not having it. Everyone's legs getting mashed. Now I'm gonna... Martin Odegaard is class in this game. Has that special something. He really does. He's good in this game. Like, what bench defender can I get? I don't know. Defender. Ake. Mata. Look, you lot, you see, the problem I've got is I don't know how to scout. I mean, I don't know how to delegate offers. So, what your boy's gonna do is delegate an offer. Oh. Maybe not for him since he's just moved, but we'll get Fred. Delegate to buy. So start offer at 15, no higher than 20. Oh, that's cool. I like this. Nice, they accepted. Now, accept offer. Now, delegators. Start wage at 35k. Start wage at 40. So start wage at 40k. Bro. I'm just gonna negotiate because this is extra. My nigga, contracts are so hard. Sporadic. Yeah, you won't get not much game time, but it's all Gucci. Say hi to the stream.
Hello.
Hi guys. Hi Elisa. I mean, guys, that's my little sister. Just saying hi into the stream. Jeez, he wants a lot of money for a rotation player. I mean, I'll get him just because he can defend, but bro, I'm not looking to pay that much. He's clearly fulfilled the potential of only 81 rated, which I mean isn't terrible. He's a sporadic player anyway, but my daisy's bad. No. You see, his defending's good though. You can play. I'll play him at centre back if I want to play him at centre back. Okay, that's just it. No, should be. No. They don't know me. All right, Fred is number 8. Ain't nobody got time for that. I would rather Ross Barkley got number 8 and Fred got 14. 14 suits him more, and Ross Barkley deserves the number 8 more. He's a better player. Oh, they're both the same age. They're both old. It's just a bit annoying. I want to see what it's saying. But rather than bringing the noise for Fred. Don't know me. Werder Bremen have 2 of their classy players, and so do Manchester City. So they must be on form. I could see us playing them in the final. I could see us playing them. Love should be. No. All right, I'll be back. Hey guys, I'm back and simming takes so long sometimes. So, round of 16 against Inter Milan. Oh shit, what are you crying about? Oh, respect. He's not crying. Someone loves you, it's changed. Yes, he's not crying about something. Thank you. So, how is the squad looking? We are without a very good player for us, but this guy, he'll do. He's got 90 pace. He's got good dribbling. He'll do. Like 88 pace, 90 pace, same thing. And let's see what happens. good. Let's go. Two, one in the first leg away at the San Siro. And it's Haaland to pick up a brace. Well, what do you know? When no one steps up, it's Erling Braut Haaland. Yep. He's been here since the start. He's been here since the start. Bremen can rely on Erling Haaland. Brilliant player. I'll put him there so that when they're simulating, when he comes back from injury, he automatically slots back into the squad so he doesn't get unhappy. Oh no, Eggenstein has a suspension and he is crucial. But as I said, we've got too many midfielders. We have three midfielders, two attacking, one defensive. We have three, and yeah. Man said this guy met Johnny Carey. What a lucky guy. At the airport. What a lucky guy. Johnny Carey is one of my favourite YouTubers. Johnny, if you ever see this, which you won't, your YouTube videos are sirty. They're so sick. He's got banging videos. This nigga don't even look gassed to be in this photo. I'd be so gassed to be in Johnny Carey's photo. Oh no, we have so many suspensions and cards and I don't know what to do. This has gave me very, very bad depression now that I have to see this. Diggalo, kicker. No, kicker. No, now, will we step up home at the Werder Bremen Stadium that I don't actually remember how to pronounce, but it's like the Wissenhofer something arena. No, not arena. But it's 1-1, and what do you know? It's the rotational player, the Ricardo Quaresma region, who steps up, and the Frank Ribery region couldn't step up that game, but maybe he had an alright game, I don't know, but Ricardo Quaresma, he steps up, he did, he really did. Yeah. I got bad anxiety seeing all those red cards and suspended players and injuries, and you see what I mean? Injuries try killing this rebuild. We narrowly made it out. We hardly made it out of the round of 16. We made it out on one goal in out of the two legs. That is not good. That is not good. Kicker. Oh, okay. Reach a semi-final. We will try and reach the final and to win the Champions League. The Champions League is a must-win this season. Or I don't know what to do. We didn't make any good signings in January. Was kind of just offloading and buying more deadwood. Not deadwood, but rotation. And I don't know how much more this squad can be improved from what it is. I mean, it's most players in the squad are 90 or approaching 90 overall. And how many over 90? All right, how many over 88 rated players have we got? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 out of 11. I don't know if I want to become Spain manager. Why not? I've already been the manager of the Netherlands, but I'll be Spain just because Spain's pretty cool. Let me check Spain's squad. Oyarzabal, what a good player. Cracking a plug. Fabian, really good. Really good player. Rodri is better than Marina. Meunier, nah, he's not going there. This guy is actually a good player. Maybe I should have took him more seriously. Can Grimaldo, is he actually good at defending? He is actually alright at defending. Dani Olmo, there's no way I'm not putting him in the squad. There's no way Dani Olmo is not getting put in the squad. Put in the spliff. That's it. I'm gonna do something so weird. You guys will probably hate watching my videos after I do this. Saul is, yeah, Saul can play at left back. I knew it. Kepa, Riza Balaga, how old's David De Gea? Kepa's the new wave of talent. And I don't like Carnival. Right, let's see, have we got any wingers on the bench? No, we haven't. Instead, we've got two fullbacks. I mean, I've already put a winger on the bench. He's old man. I feel like this is a story of a paedophile. Oh, these old men cannot tell me what to do. Like, it's a bit sus. The crime here in my country has dropped like a fly. Because of this coronavirus. How old's Danny Ceballos? I like Ceballos because he plays for Arsenal. This guy he doesn't seem like he's the best player. Junior Firpo. Nah, they've got too many good fullbacks. I think Thiago Alcantara is a very good, classy player. He should get more credit for how good he is in real life. Thiago Alcantara. Oh, this guy actually becomes pretty decent. Pablo Fornals, he's probably like 29. So this is the guy that Bayern Munich have as their starting keeper. That's the guy who makes all them sick saves. Yeah, Thiago's going right into Ferran Torres. How old is he? Oh, he did not fulfill his potential well enough this career. But, yeah. That's what the squad's looking like. And what with the squad, I give him a hard and I mean it. Yeah, I think De Gea's just like, you can't play anymore. Kepa's the new, like, he should be the French number, I mean Spanish number one soon anyway. Now back to Werder Bremen. Pickford starts, we've got a full starting 11 apart from Ousmane Dembele, who could not play, and 2-0 against Monaco at home. No away goals, really important. How? Yeah. They just want to give me high blood pressure. How's Kylian Mbappe not playing? What the hell? Oh no. Finally, Alright, not full strength. Usman is still injured. But what can I say, it is what it is. We demolish them away. In the back getting live off. Alright. Surely we're not gonna get beat by Inter Milan in the first leg. Like, I mean AC. We've beat their rivals Inter, who are better than them in real life. Maybe Inter Milan have stepped up. They've got a good keeper in Donnarumma. Dembele, I don't think he can play. I'm not gonna let him play this. Alright. Yeah, Dembele is not playing for sure. And this Donny always seems to do alright for himself. So we have the two regens on the whole left side. Alright, first of all, they have an amazing team. Yeah. I saw Van de Beek, Rashford, and Donnarumma, and they've got a good team. But Neymar Jr. for the win, am I right? Yeah, two away goals. Two goals at the San Siro. Maybe we're in an alright position here. Because by the time we'll have everybody fully fit, hopefully, if no one gets injured. Just please don't get injured and affected too badly, and will be such a good team. I had a perfect picture. It was all laid out for me. I feel like I'm in love with the paint fam because it's the same old story. Same old question, what's your body count? Who be linking before me? And I hope you don't ask me back because my life is never so good. You know what happens? You know what happens when you do this to AA manager, yeah? You know what happens? You're taking the piss now, mate. Since you clearly get vexed everything. That's what happens, mate. Alright, just no one get injured. Yes, we're through! Boys, we're through to the Champions League final. We're through to the Champions League final. You know love takes time, but relationship goals got everyone rushing. You get a feeling it's way too good to be true. And well. When you look at who it is, you got Real in the final. And well, when you look at that, Real Madrid in the final. We really wanted to win the league, but we won the league last season. Let's see. We won the league last season. Take it easy, it's your last game. I mean, we went a bit aggressive mode, aggro, but. Okay guys, now this is the big game. This is Champions League final. The Champions League final, a fully fit squad. And all right, this is the squad report and how it's looking. So appearances, delete. A lot of appearances for Matthias De Ligt. Same goes for Maximilian Eggenstein, Aaron Wan-Bissaka. If I waited for a fifth season, so Neymar Jr. goes down by one, unfortunately. Erling Braut Haaland, by far the best striker in the world. Damian Pickford, best keeper, no doubt about it. Ousmane Dembele, you know, he's getting to that best status. Ross Barkley, he made a few appearances for himself. Dalvez even made 14. Adam Holsek has got very good at his time at Roma, and this guy for me is like the Sergio Aguero of the team. I'm sorry you guys didn't get to see him in action, but he was an important player. So I'm happy he's doing well at Atletico. And now, top goal scorer is Neymar Jr. drawn with Erling Braut Haaland. Erling Braut Haaland is the top goal scorer because if you see, he's actually scored the same amount of goals, but in less games. Assist king, Neymar, clearly. Neymar still shows his class at his age. As 31 years old, but he's still got the class. Maximilian Eggenstein, 8 assists, 11 goals. Really good tally for the young'un. Now Damian Pickford, 16 clean sheets. Lovely. Attributes is a big one a lot of people like to see. First, oldest player. These are the oldest. They have not went down yet, surprisingly. Neymar has went down. We are a pretty young squad now. Here's all our amazing players. There. Morale. Who's upset? The regens are upset, that's fair enough. Overall change. Who have been the biggest winners in terms of growth? I'd say they were pretty good this season. The two regens, as unhappy as they are. That's life, isn't it? It's just, so that's it. People getting decline. And a really interesting thing we should check out. Let's see who, wage, Kylian Mbappe, of course, the people I got for free, very, and now here we have our very expensive players in all of their glory. That is a rapid decline in, look, Kiyonte, 51 to 19 mil. So guys, player of the rebuild is, little drum roll, Erling Braut, the number 9 Haaland is a player of the rebuild, guys. Now, we're going to attend press conference. And we're going to take in all the Champions League.
Thank you for your patience.
You're about to... We worked hard to get it. And it's as simple as that. Werder Bremen home kit versus Real home kit. Four minutes per half. Guys, this, we're approaching the end of the rebuild. If you guys enjoyed, no, I'll save that for later. I'll save that for later, my little plugs. Guys, this is the Champions League final in the Johan Cruyff Arena in the Netherlands, the Ajax Stadium, the Ajax home ground. Welcome us. And here is Kylian Mbappe. Easy for Courtois. Head it away. Now Eggenstein. Usman Dembele. Did you see that flick? Are you fucking kidding me? I just flicked it over like that and I was about to bang it for the first goal. Anyway, 6 minutes in, we have had a few chances already. All right. Bremen. Oh no. Werder Bremen. jeez, what the? Okay. We've got senior players. We've got a mix of experience and loads of it's experience, really. They're just all young talents. What a nice goal. Neymar Jr. gets on the scorer's sheet. 19 minutes played. 1-0 Werder Bremen FC. SV Werder Bremen. Now Hernandez, he can go by his own, but he passes it. Lovely skill from the youngster. Kylian Mbappe. No, it's not. It's a bird. It's a plane. It's Neymar. He scored. He scored. I even thought that was Mbappe waiting at the black post, at the back post. Neymar Jr. is on fire. I was actually contemplating signing him because I was like, should I not? Because he's a bit old, he's getting on in age. Oh, fuck. Mbappe just clattered him. Mbappe rossed his clot. It's only a yellow. It's only a yellow. Thank God. Mbappe's got to be careful because I'm not getting the best player in the world subbed off. Now, Werder Bremen have not been winners a lot in there. History, but recently, in their recent history under AA manager, they have been very good the last 4 years, four-time Champions League contenders. And Werder Bremen, really, really good from them. Kylian Mbappe gets on the scorer's sheet. We love you, Werder. We do. We love you, Werder Bremen. We do. We love you, Werder. We do. Oh, Werder Bremen, we love you. Dun dun. Come on, no, I'm trying to not defend it so there can be shots and the game can be interesting. But no, it's too easy. Like, I can go ahead and score 9 goals this game, probably. I'm not even exaggerating. That's so bad. Oh, and I'm 30 at using goalkeepers in this game. Now Damien Pickford's in the middle. Fists it away. Fists me daddy away. Lovely flicks. Dembele. Oh, did you see that? His ankles just got mashed. His ankles just got cracked, bro. This is what I mean. I'm sometimes cold at this game. Like, I'm sometimes very good at this game. I actually tried clearing it. They won't. That's Talisca the Brazilian. He is a free kick master. Are you for real? No, no way. I thought I saved it. Okay, alright. Bring it on. Bring it on. Bring on the heat. That was a beautiful free kick. No doubt about it, but the way it went in was so jammy. I'm a bit vexed. I mean, he got the ball kind of, but whenever I do that, I get booked. So I mean, it should have been a penalty. A swear I just saw the Nigerian flag. Look at all the Nigerian background. Alright. It's an alright finish from an amazing striker. You don't need much more. Erling Braut Haaland has scored a banger. No, I'm joking. It wasn't a terrible goal. A goal is a goal. Come on, just rip apart my defense and go score. You're serious. We've got a team of all the best players in the world. And I'm letting you go through, and you're not going through. What a retard. You're not going to score from there. You're not going to score from that angle. My defender's got your whole team's attack on lock. They won't allow it. Lovely skill. Oh, I thought I was going to... I was going to fake shot him and then embarrass him. Fuck. Pickford, quick, Pickford. Nice touch. Distribute. Head it. Pass it out wide. Flick it over. Back your back and just dig it. Junior Firpo. Anderson Talisca. Yeah, he's Brazilian. He's the 31. Jesus Christ. Alright, fair enough. Lovely, from Jesus Renier. He's one of my career mode favourites. He's a starting striker for them, and he's good, so... What can I say? Now Hernandez, he can pass to Dembele. He goes in, he goes on by himself. He breaks Nelson Semedo's ankles. He crosses it in. Now guys, everyone knows you should be careful for my corners. All right, Balotelli. Aguero! Oh! I'm telling you, my corners are deadly. Oh, Jonathan David. Balotelli. Aguero! Oh, Aguero! That was beautiful. He doesn't miss those. Jonathan David don't miss those. Do you see that? Jonathan David, he don't miss those. Top corner, top draw technique. And it flew into the air. Thibaut Courtois could not get to it. Classy from big Jonathan David. Real Madrid have a massive fan base, but in recent years Werder Bremen have wanted to be known small. They've always been small, but they've been on the upcome. In the 2020 season they were on the verge of relegation until a bright light came through. You already know who it is. It was manager, and he took them, and turned them his. Mbappe masterclass today. Alright, I got to score one more goal, and then they've got to do a certain celebration. Will I tell you what that celebration is? If I don't score, then yeah. But if I do score, then I will do the celebration. So I won't tell you yet. And if I can score with Mbappe, that would be handy. And I did score, and I'll do the celebration. Kylian Mbappe obviously got to come over and celebrate. Erling Brau Haaland, player of the career, he heads it in. He heads it in. There's nothing the keeper can do. He's big, he's strong, he's Haaland, he's Haaland, he's big, he's strong, he's Haaland. Alright, now. Yeah, lovely. Neymar with a little bit of skill. Oh, why is Ousmane Dembele's skills like, he's good, but why are his skills so not working in FIFA? They never work. I told you, I told you, what a certy baller. What a certy baller. And he puts it past goalkeeper Courtois, who cannot save for his life. What a shot. Neymar's no-look goal. That was a no-looker. Oh. 8-2. Imagine getting beaten. 8-2. Could never be me. It seems like a realistic scoreline from the like to get thrashed by. Like, I know it's not common, but it's double how much Real Madrid beat Juventus by in one of the Champions League finals. I think it was 2017 or 2016, but. Last attack. And that's 9-2. Thank you, boys. Good day at the office. Well, here's the replay. You have to say it's been a thorn in the side of the opposition all match. It's a good finish and a really deserved hat-trick. This shit is so easy, bro. This game's too easy. This is the team that did the treble. This is the team that have done the domestic treble, the domestic double, the normal treble, the international treble at this rate. Like, look at this. It's everybody. Champione, champione, champione. Champione, Bremen. You guys wanted to see the celebrations? No, I'm joking. Of course. Champions League winners. Werder Bremen. Best team in the world. Best team in Europe. Well, it's giving something back. His fans have travelled all over the place following their team. Now they get to join in the celebrations, go into the crowd and give them the cup. That's what I say. Well, then it might never find its way to the trophy cabinet, Lee. Guys, I've been working on this Bremen career mode for quite a few days, and what can I say, guys? It feels good, man. Feels good. All in all, if you guys enjoyed, thank you so much. I really appreciate the guys who have watched this video. You guys are so great, and thank you for all your support and everything. But all in all, this did take me quite a while, and I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope it was entertaining. And yeah, I tried my best with this video to make it good. So guys, that's the end of the video. If you liked, please leave a like, subscribe, and turn on those post noties. It's been your boy Mogul, and I'll see you in the next one. Safe.